is Maisha coming to you today from www.thatitgirl.com with an absolutely awesome Sephora skincare and makeup haul. I think all the items that I have should have me set for the fall season. So if you are interested in watching, please stay tuned. Okay, so these items that I'm going to show you all from Sephora are ones that I have collected maybe over the last month or so. I purchased this Anastasia Beverly Hills Dip Brow Pomade in dark brown, and I got this because I've really just kind of been looking to revamp my whole eyebrow routine, and I've only used this about once or twice since I bought it. I'm still undecided about this, and the reason being is that it works very well. I mean, my eyebrows stay put all day, but I'm not sure quite how I feel about the color. So I'm gonna use this some more and we'll see how this holds up. Okay, so I went on and decided to invest in a new foundation, and I don't know why, because I still absolutely love my Makeup Forever HD foundation in number 178. I actually just repurchased a bottle maybe about 3 months ago. But because I'm a what? You guessed it, a product junkie, I just had to get my hands on this YSL foundation. But this is the YSL Le Teint Encre de Peau. I really love this because this is a liquid to powder foundation. I wore this a few times, you know, on some of the hotter days down here in Texas, and it really held up against this Texas heat. This top comes off, and of course it has, you know, a cap, and when you take the cap off, it has this little wand that is connected to the cap, and you're actually supposed to take this wand and rub it on your face. I'm not sure how much I like that, because again, you're dipping the wand in, you're rubbing on your face, and then you're dipping it back into your foundation. I tend to be more of a fan of pumps. I like foundations that have pumps on it. So I may try to figure out if I can find a pump that will actually fit this, but this stuff is really good. It matches my skin tone exactly. I got the Too Faced Love Blush, long lasting 16 hour blush. And I think probably what really attracted me to these two blush colors were the packaging. I mean, it is so cute. It is heart-shaped blush with Too Faced on the front and gold letters. And then when you open it up, each blush has, you know, two cute little bunny rabbits, and it says Too Faced, and it's so cute, and of course I'm a sucker for packaging. This first color is Your Love Is King, and it is kind of a berry tone blush, and I really like this for the apples of my cheeks. Now this blush to me is not very pigmented. I did have to really layer this on, so I think for women like me with deeper, darker skin tones, you know, I just really had to go in too many times to kind of get that color payoff. And so the next color that I picked up was the I Will Always Love You. And, you know, this on my skin tone is more or less a highlight color. It looks like a very nice peachy orange in the packaging, but when I put it on, I got absolutely no orange payoff, but I did get some highlighting effect. So I'm gonna hang on to this just when I'm going for a more natural makeup look, and we'll see how these work. From Sephora is this Marc Jacobs lip gloss, and this is in Taboo. And yes, 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 I have to just give Marc Jacobs a round of applause, because this is an awesome color. You know, I think I'm just gonna put some on right now. Let's see. It's kind of minty. Y'all, this is my first time wearing this. You know, Marc Jacobs has slowly been becoming one of my go-to brands for lipstick, nail polish, lip gloss. You know, you all don't sleep on Marc Jacobs. He has a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful makeup line. So I got a few skincare items, and the first one is the Clinique Clarifying Lotion number 3, and this is for combination to oily skin. I know this has kind of gotten mixed reviews online because alcohol is the second ingredient. I would definitely let you all know how this works out for me, because again, this stuff has gotten mixed reviews online, but
hey, it's worth a try.
So the next product I got was the Glam Glow Super Cleanse Daily Clearing Cleanser. And this is a mud to foam facial cleanser. Now, I only got the travel size because as much as possible, I always like to try products before I get the full size. So I really like this cleanser so far. And I use this as my nighttime cleanser. And it just really gets rid of all the impurities. I noticed that my pores are shrinking. It might be psychological. I don't know if they're really actually shrinking, but they do seem smaller and more refined. And I really love the fact that this cleanser kind of has a tingly sensation. It smells like licorice, and it has a tingly sensation that just really makes you feel like you're getting deep down in your pores, getting all the dirt and crud out. Love this. I am definitely going to get the full size once I am done with this particular one. So I decided to buy yet another pricey makeup remover, and this is the Clinique Take the Day Off Cleansing Balm. And this is pretty good stuff so far. I have used this about 3 or 4 times in the last week, and it is a balm. You just dip your finger into it, rub it all over your face, add water, and it kind of transforms into a milky cleanser. And I use this before I do anything else with my makeup removal process. This is step number one. All right, that's it, you all. I am done. That is everything I got from Sephora. I hope you all enjoyed this haul. Make sure you are subscribed to my channel, and make sure you're following me on Instagram. Make sure you follow me on Twitter and Facebook. And don't forget to visit me on my blog, www.thatitgirl.com. Talk to you later, it girls. Bye.